Reggae Jam 2012. This is Reggaeville. My name is Munchi, and this man's name is Cornel Campbell. Cornel with one L.
The original Gargan. Well, yeah. One L.
One L, Cornel.
What really happened apparently was that back in the days,
yeah,
Bonnie Lee made a mistake with my name and spelled it with two L.
Yeah.
And from that one LP come out, all LP them come out with two L.
Exactly.
And the people them get used to the two L.
So you just stuck with it.
I just stuck with it.
Okay.
Trust me. Uncle, when I really drawing a check, it have a right name.
Yes, and on the passport.
On the passport, you know that?
Of course.
Yeah.
You've been to Reggae Jam stage just a while ago. Did you enjoy your performance today?
I always enjoy my performance, you know, because I put out the best of my ability to the people. Them.
Yeah.
I don't sing for myself alone, I sing for the world.
Yeah.
For the, as a global thing, me sing for. Okay. I sing for all nations. So I'll do the best that I can. Yeah.
It was a wonderful performance today. I really enjoyed myself.
It have to be wonderful because when I see the people, I know that them love me.
Yeah.
And I know that I have to do what I have to do. Because I'm buying records and I'm buying CDs. I can't disappoint them.
No, you can't.
No.
And you're doing that for a long, long while now because you recorded for the first time, I think it was 1956. You were, how old were you?
Baba, 1945. Yeah. I'm now 67.
So what got an 11-year-old boy into a studio?
I was a Christian. I was in the church singing, and a friend of mine, were really admire me singing. Him said to me, said, "Boy, me sound better than all the guys I'm here on the radio." He was 2 years older than me. His name was Kenneth Samuel, and we used to go to the same school together. And what he do? He said, well, he went to look for a recording company in those times in Jamaica. As it was a long, long time ago,
yeah,
you never have no Wolpa recording company. You'd have Federal Recording Company, which was run by the Koori. And he thought that Rico did recording. So we went and see Rico. Rico, with disappointment, said, but I don't do recording. But I can put you onto a man and so Coxon's down beat.
Oh, wow.
And that was the opportunity we had, and we make use of it.
What did your parents say when you, as a little you, just went into the studio and recorded a song? They never said anything?
Of course, that was a joke because my mother used to hide me from my father.
Okay.
My father was very strict. He never wanted, because I said, oh, little boy, like you, I bleach at night time. I'm run with some. My mother always put up with it for me to sing.
Yes.
Because when the band them come pick me up, them used to hide and park them car far up the road. I'm a judge my father and put on my suit and my things and walk through the back door and gone. And my father look for me and can't find me. Yeah, I've been through those complications before, yeah.
But even through all those complications and everything, you maintained your career over all these years and decades. So you never thought of doing anything but music?
I'm a printer.
Okay.
Not really, I'm a printer. I should have said I was a printer.
You were a printer.
Yeah, because my mother always tell me, say, in those days that I must find a security, a job. I can't just live off a source of singing. So what I did, I work with Sir Coxon Dombey. I'm print record label like Roland and Powell label, Darlington label, Supreme label, as a little boy. And I'm a tutor management of Cyril. He was a great printer, so I used to print the labels them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alton Ellis was the one who said to me, said, boy, Cornel, you know why you not make it? Because you have to let go to work and sing alone.
Yeah.
Because through me singing, I'm working, I can't make it, you know, the singing.
Yeah.
Because I take up more time working as I was working for security. But I just let go to working half a while.
Yeah.
And just sing professionally.
Exactly. And you were not always singing solo, but you were also with groups, the Eternals, the Uniques.
So many groups.
Yeah.
Groups like the Sensations, the Bell Stars, the Uniques, the Tech. Boy, so much groups.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what do you prefer, singing solo or singing with a group, or what's the most significant difference of it?
Well, to be honest, I love to sing by myself. But preferable, a group is nice. Because if you notice some album them, I sing with a group, but I couldn't take the problem with the groups them. Sometimes I have too much work. Like when I found the Sensations, and like when I write, after the writing, and I'm going to look girls, and I'm going to spree. And when real time come for recording, that's the time everybody has shuffled up for good or something. And I used to vex with it.
Yeah.
So I just make up my mind and go solo. Because me is me. Uncle, me alone can do what I have to do. Sometimes guys don't turn up a rehearsal, and then I get it aggravated and really distressful. So I just say, you know what? I mean him Colonel Campbell. But it's a good Colonel Campbell. Yeah.
So Colonel Campbell did a lot of recordings. You're always touring. You're always still very productive throughout all the years. So what can the fans expect from you in the near future?
A lot of things, because as long as I'm alive and Jehovah God through Jesus Christ is with me, I will always put out the best of my ability to the world. I will. Because that's what I was born to do. I'm born to entertain people. And I won't stop. Until God tells me when to stop. Yeah.
So all the best for that. God's blessings. Keep on doing your thing. It's wonderful. So thank you.
And thank you too for interviewing me. You know?
Thanks a lot.
It was a pleasure. Great pleasure.
Yes, mine too.